Today, we're going to be looking at how sharpening works, and specifically how you can use this information with the Photoshop Unsharp Mask. Now, I'm picking the Unsharp Mask because it's quite simple to understand what's going on. Let's start then by creating what we call a sharpening wedge. Now, the way to do this in Photoshop, select the Marquee tool. We can then use that to draw out a rectangle. Now, this will form our sharpening wedge. Now, to draw the wedge, we need a gradient. Now, I've got mine set up to go from black through to white. And I'm just going to click on one side of the marquee and drag across to the other. When I release, that creates my gradient. I'm now going to copy this. And now I'm going to paste that. Now, that creates me a new layer in the layers window. I can turn off the original and you can see the new layer. What I'm going to do now is select the Move tool, and I'm going to use this to transform the new layer that I've created by flipping it through 180 degrees. I can now move that down and align it to the other gradient. So I've now got two gradients running in opposite directions that go right next to each other. Now for a bit of theory about how sharpening actually works. Let's zoom in on the gradient. Over here on the left side, you can see that we've got a very dark area and a very white area, literally going from black to white. Now notice how easy it is to see the sharp edge between the two in the gradient. Now let's move over towards the centre of the gradients where they cross over. Here, the tones are very, very similar and it's very difficult to see the difference between the two. It's this difference in contrast between two adjacent areas that creates the sharpening effect. If we want to make one gradient stand out more against the other, what we need to do is make this edge here more like the edge here. In other words, rather than being two similar grey tones, we enhance the edge and make one darker and one lighter. This is what sharpening does. It's a contrast adjustment along an edge. And I'll show you how that works in just a moment with the Unsharp Mask. Now, before I do this, I just want to create what we call a stamp layer. And that will combine these two layers together. This means that I'm now sharpening one layer that has both of the gradients on it. So let's open the Unsharp Mask and have a look at it. You'll find it in the Filters menu and then under the Sharpen submenu. Now straight away you can see we've got some enhancement going on along the edge now. This amount slider here is what controls how strong that enhancement is. So for example, at the moment we've got it at 1%, so it's having virtually no effect at all. Watch what happens in the areas here where the tones are very similar grey as I move the slider up. As I increase the slider, what we're starting to see is that an edge here is being created, and that edge is making grey appear greyer and light grey appear lighter. What determines whether a tone becomes lighter or darker is how near it is to the mid-tone grey value of 128. So if something is lighter than a mid-tone, the contrast enhancement applied by the amount slider makes it lighter. If it's darker than a mid-tone, then the contrast enhancement makes it darker. And the further I move this slider up to the right, the more that contrast adjustment is applied so that it becomes stronger and stronger. And when you can see it at its maximum value, it's affecting almost the entire length of this gradient until you get to the mid-tone here where there's no difference between the two pixels, so they're both the same value. That's where it has no effect. Now look at the width of this edge that's being created. At the moment it's really easy to see. Now this is called a sharpening halo. Now a lot of people talk about sharpening halos as if they're a problem. And they're not. A sharpening halo is always produced. If it wasn't produced, you wouldn't get the sharpening effect. The problem comes if you make the sharpening halo too strong, as we have done here. The amount is at 500, so literally every edge is going to be black and white, and that's very easy to see when you look at an image, and you don't want that. So typically you'd reduce the slider down here to where it becomes less obvious. Now I'm going to leave it up at maximum value for the moment, and the reason is because I want to show you this other slider, the radius slider. Now the radius slider controls how wide an edge is being created. Now at the moment it's 4 pixels. If I push it up further to 45 pixels, you can see a massive edge is being created. If we move it down to around 1, you can see that hardly any edge is being created. And if we combine the two together so that we've got not too strong a contrast enhancement and a small radius, what we see is that there's now a distinct edge between the two gradients, but that's very hard to detect even though I'm magnified at 200%. Now the final slider that we've got here is threshold. So let's have a look. We'll strengthen this, we'll make it wider so you can see it, and we'll push the amount up again so we've got a very distinct edge. Now as we said before, you can see that edge extending right the way along the gradients until we get to the middle. What determines whether or not Photoshop detects an edge is the threshold. So what the threshold's doing is it's testing adjacent pixels, and it's trying to see how much of a difference there is between the two. And when we've got it down at 0, basically it will enhance any difference at all that it finds in pixel brightness. If though I move this now to the right, what we see is that the pixels have to have more of a difference between their levels of brightness before the enhancement takes place. And that's why we're not seeing any sharpening in this central area now. And the further I move this slider over to the right, the less effect it's having. Notice that the effect now is in this left side of where the two gradients cross. And I can move that all the way out here to where there's literally no effect and no sharpening between the two, because there has to be a massive difference between adjacent pixels before they become sharpened. If we pick something like 60 pixels, what we're saying is that the difference between the lightest and brightest areas has to be at least 60 difference on the tonal scale. And remember, the tonal scale runs from 0 to 255, 0 being black, 255 being white. The radius slider now, we can reduce that down, so we'll move it back down to a default of around 1, which is usually a good amount. And if we move that down now to around 96%, what we see here is an enhancement of the two gradients in the sharpening wedge to make that edge stand out. So I'll apply that. I'll go back to 100%, and you can see that the two gradients are a little sharper than they were before. We've enhanced this sharpness, but we haven't made it so obvious that we detect a problem. Let's look now at applying what we've learned to this image, and we'll sharpen it using the Unsharp Mask. Now I've already created my new layer for the sharpening, and I'm going to zoom in to 100% on the background. I'm also going to look at this particular area here so that I can monitor it for sharpening. Now it's already quite sharp, but we can probably make it better using the mask. I'm going to now take the Unsharp Mask filter and apply it. Now the default settings that I've got are just the ones that I was using earlier, and I can change these to something that's more suitable for this image. So let's start by pushing up the sharpening to a higher amount. And if you remember, this creates the sharpening effect by enhancing the edges with greater contrast. Now as I've done that, you can see an edge very faintly starting to appear along the headland here. And if I make that a little bit wider using the radius slider, you can see we've got a sharpening halo that's quite ugly. So let's pull that back down for a little bit, down to about 110. And we'll also make this sharpening radius a little bit narrower at about 1.7. And we'll move it down still further because I can detect the edge a little bit too much. So at 1.4, it doesn't look too bad, and we can probably get away with applying a little bit more sharpness. Now the other thing that's happening is that we're sharpening with the threshold at zero, so that means everything is being sharpened where Photoshop detects a difference between adjacent pixels. And I don't really want that because there's a lot of sort of misty water from the long exposure here. So I'm just going to move that up to something like 30. Now what that's doing is it's concentrating the sharpening onto the rocks where there's a greater tonal difference between adjacent pixels. And it also means that I can push the sharpness up probably further still, and the radius just a little bit more. Now I still have to be careful because on this edge here there's probably quite a difference between the sky and the rocks, and it will still show an edge. But let's turn off the preview for the moment, and I'm not sure if you can see it on the video, but actually it's made a reasonable difference to the rocks in terms of the sharpening, and I can probably drop the threshold down a little bit further there. Now given that this is only the unsharp mask and not the smart sharpen filter, we don't have any controls that we can use to get rid of the halo. All we have to do is try to not make the halo too strong. And that looks about right. If we were using the smart sharpen filter, we actually have options there to fade the sharpening in the highlights and the shadows so that we can control the halos better. For now, I'm happy with the result. Let's click OK. We can turn that off where we can see there is a difference between the sharpening. If I turn it on, you can see that, especially in these areas where we've got the lichens on the rocks. I hope you find this useful. I'm Robin Whalley. You've been watching Lenscraft. I'll see you next time for another video.